Tonight on Tom's River Schools Today, we will take a look at how one man got stuck in a bad situation.
And as always, we have a look at some events from around the school district. Tom's River Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
For outcasts and rebels, or anyone who just dares to be different. And you've been trying for so long to find out where your place is, but in their narrow minds, there's no room for anyone who dares to do something different. Oh, but listen for a minute. Trust the one who's been where you are, wishing all it was sticks and stones. Those words cut deep, but they don't mean you're
Hello and welcome to Tom's River Schools Today for Thursday, February 8th. I'm Michael Boldo.
And I'm Grace Danesco. Later on tonight, we'll check out your weather.
But up first tonight, we take a look at our elementary schools and our elementary's happening segment.
Starting off our elementary happenings, parents, please check the student's website for all important information.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day.
Hi, I'm Ryan McGilloy with TV21's Random Fact of the Day. Michelangelo carved his self-portrait into the locks of hair on the Statue of David.
Feel the need for speed? Then get out your show snubbles. Jeremy Roth has today's look at this.
With the 2018 Winter Olympics looming, athletes of a different kind gathered in New Mexico. Behold, the annual Angel Fire Resort World Championship Shovel Races. Here's the scoop. Racers of all ages compete by sitting on a standard aluminum snow shovel. They get two shots at clocking the fastest time down the mountain. Top speeds regularly exceed 70 miles an hour. According to the resort, shovel races began in the 1970s. Lift operators would ride their shovels down the mountain at the end of their shift. Organized races have been held at the resort for over 39 years. Hey, maybe when they're done, they can send some of those shovels to Paris because the city shut down because of heavy snowfall. The Eiffel Tower shuttered its doors to tourists as images on the attraction's Twitter account show the city blanketed with snow. Residents are literally skiing through the city streets. Well, the world's most powerful modern rocket, the Falcon Heavy, took flight from Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It was built by SpaceX, headed by billionaire Tesla CEO Elon Musk. Speaking of Tesla, yeah, now there's a Tesla in space. Musk put a cherry red Tesla Roadster into orbit around the sun with a dummy driver and a David Bowie song along for the ride. Talk about a space oddity. For Take a Look at This, I'm Jeremy Roth.
You ever have a Tesla? It's time to take a trip around the world on our 60-second road trip. Can you guess where we are today? I was tired of my lady. We'd been together too long. Like a worn-out recording of a favorite song. So while she lay there sleeping, I read the paper in bed. Columns, there was this letter I read. If you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain, if you're not into yoga, if you have half a brain, if you'd like making love at midnight in the dunes on the Cape, then I'm the love that you've looked for. Write to me.
The City Council of Angels Camp, California, appointed a new mayor Tuesday, and this remarkable woman isn't just the youngest in the city's history. She's also breaking records with people for disabilities. Sarah Zenderman spoke with her.
If you didn't know, she's
the first deaf female mayor in the United States and the youngest mayor of an Angels Camp.
Pretty impressive, huh? This is Amanda Fallendorf. She's 31 years old, lost her hearing as a baby, and is making history.
It's an honor to be seen in that leadership role.
Fallendorf wanted to sign through this interview to show the value of American Sign Language and that her hearing won't stop her.
I see it as my superpower. I think it's a wonderful thing to use.
But superpowers don't protect her from everything. She says people have their doubts because of her age.
It takes a lot of confidence to stand up in front of those people and say, yes, I can.
And faces challenges to keep up with her hearing. But Fallendorf has two interpreters at meetings. That helps and allows her to bring her unique perspective to Angels Camp.
Oh, you guys set up?
Fallendorf was elected to city council at just 27 years old. 4 years later, she's the leader of this small town. Her priorities? Economic growth and viability through preserving the history of this area. And as the youngest mayor this town has ever seen, she wants to include the younger generation's voice in that.
Their ideas and their family are going to be here for a long time.
And show the deaf community greatness is possible.
We can do everything else hearing people can do. But just can't hear.
In Angels Camp, Sarah Zendanam, Fox 40 News.
It's now time for us to take a look at dictionary.com's word of the day. Today's word is embargo, meaning an order of a government prohibiting the departure of commercial ships from its ports. And now for your sentence of the day. The United Nations imposed an arms embargo against the country. Now we're going to take a short break, but coming up, we are going to look at our immediate happenings.
And we also take a look at your weather, so stick around. We'll be right back.
Every year, 1 million families face losing their homes to foreclosure. Because they don't know what to do, they do nothing. If you're in danger of losing your home, call us, because nothing is worse than doing nothing. Thank you.
Welcome back. Starting off our intermediate happenings at Intermediate East, attention 8th grade parents and guardians. The yearbook ad order deadline has been extended. Orders will now be accepted until February 16th.
Moving to Intermediate North, Tree Club is sponsoring the annual pet supply drive for the Jersey Shore Animal Center. You can help by donating dog or cat food, treats, toys, and supplies to the collection bin in the cafeteria. Items needed are posted on signs throughout the school.
It is now time for environmental tip of the day. Each day we'll bring you a tip that will help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
Hi, I'm Ben Cagno, and this is your environmental tip of the day. Green to go, not brewing at home? Take a travel cup to your favorite Java joint. They may fill it at the discount.
Every day on the show, we will be bringing you a tip of the day, so stay tuned tomorrow as we give you another way to help save the environment.
School officials in Texas are thanking a 13-year-old boy for his heroic actions on a school bus last week. The middle schooler is still years away from being allowed to drive a car, let alone a bus. But when the driver suffered a medical emergency, the boy sprang into action. Jacqueline Powell has a story.
At the back first, and then when that started happening, I tried to go to the front, and I was swerving, and I fell in a couple of seats.
Seventh grader Carson Vega says when he noticed something was wrong with his bus driver on the way home from school.
Then he started making circles and stuff, and he was going off in the ditch almost every turn.
He knew he needed to act. He and another student called 911, but help wasn't arriving quickly enough.
And we were about to go out, and then I was like, no, I'm not dying. So I jerked the wheel.
The bus was heading down Highway 71, right over the Colorado River. The driver was having a medical emergency, his feet still on the pedal.
Kicked him over a little so I can get the brake and stuff, and I turned the flashes on.
Carson says there was no place to pull over, so he did all he knew to do.
Yeah, I sat on his lap and moved his hands and stuff, and then just drove.
Carson drove until the police arrived, then safely brought the bus with five other kids on board to a stop. School leaders are grateful for his heroic reaction.
It could have been a very tragic situation, but it turned out better than you could ever imagine.
Mom,
I can still hug you,
is even more grateful and proud.
There was a reason he was on that bus that day, because normally he doesn't ride it.
Usually, she picks him up. She says fate also played a role in his desire to learn about cars and driving, years out from even having his driver's license.
I fight with him all the time. Mom, let me drive down the road. Now I'm rethinking, well, I guess it's okay.
It is now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we'll take a look at your high school happenings.
Tom's River Schools Today, we'll be right back.
I'm falling apart, I'm barely breathing, with a broken heart, that's still beating, in the pain, is there healing, in your name, I find me.
The rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Starting off our high school happenings, at North, every Wednesday is Green Day. Remember to wear green to help get the word out about the need for recycling and energy conservation.
Attention students and staff, the school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-Hoo, Snapple, and water for a dollar, as well as many delicious snacks to get you energized for your after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized. Hi, schoolies. Did you know that 3 million students are absent each month because they feel unsafe at school? Make a difference in someone's life by making a new friend, sitting with a new group at lunch, or joining a new club or sport.
Need a little help with your Collins entrance essays? Having difficulty with that research paper? Or would you just like another set of eyes to proofread your assignments? The Writing Center provides tutors to help with all types of writing assignments. The Writing Center is now open every Tuesday and Thursday after school in W20. Ask your English teacher for further details.
Moving to High School South, yearbooks are currently on sale until February 25th. The price of the yearbooks are $77.25. You can currently order your yearbook at yearbookforever.com or by contacting Mr. DeMario in room F6. Members of the cast of our 2018 school musical Footloose are currently selling booster ads for the musical during homeroom. Wish a friend in the cast good luck by buying a booster for $2. A booster ad is a short message for the member of cast, crew, or orchestra.
The Art of the National Honor Society is selling heart-shaped lavender-scented bath bombs for $5 during homeroom. They make a great Valentine's Day gift.
The Interact Club is holding a pet food drive through Valentine's Day, February 14th. Interact members will visit homerooms to collect pet food or monetary donations. Please be generous.
The Key Club is sponsoring a non-perishable food drive for the needy people in Ocean County during the month of January. Let's help alleviate the problem in hunger by bringing canned goods for hungry families in our country. They will appreciate it. Take your time to donate to Ms. Adelisi's room in D6.
Now let's take a look at what grinds our gears.
Hi, I'm Taylor Pistone, and it grinds my gears when I wake up 5 minutes before my alarm clock goes off.
An amazing story of survival and friendship. A logger from Washington State finds himself in the woods alone and trapped in a sinkhole. However, 24 hours later, he made it out thanks to help from a friend. Jamie Tompkins reports.
It was dark in there like you wouldn't believe, and the hole kept getting darker and darker and darker.
Bill Burke wasn't sure he'd ever see the light of day again.
It was cold, real cold.
He spent nearly 24 hours underground after falling roughly 16 feet down a sinkhole Monday afternoon while working a logging job just outside Montesano.
All at once, all the sticks, everything was holding me up, broke, and down I went.
The dirt is still packed under his fingernails tonight. He clawed away at the soil for hours,
gathering as much loose soil as I could to get this mound. My first thought, I get that high enough, get that stick. There's a root up there. Get the stick, wedge myself. I made a couple of steps in the wall with my knife so that maybe I could,
An experienced logger. Yeah. He always carries a whistle. And he blew that whistle through the night. Fortunately, Bill's logging buddy, Jimmy Stennett, a former firefighter, had agreed to help him on the job the next morning.
I'm waiting, and his wife calls me at 6:17, and she says, "Have you seen Bill?" I says, "No." And, she says, "He never called last night."
Jimmy started searching the woods.
I finally found it, and I drove down there, and I see his truck. I don't see anybody in the cab, and the machine is parked behind it. I get out fearing the worst.
Jimmy says he drove back to an area with cell service, then called 911, then went back to search for Bill, who had cleverly tossed a clue above ground.
And over to my left, I seen his hard hat under some ferns. So I walked over, reached down and picked it up. And when I picked it up, there's a hole about this big on the other side. And I looked down, I seen a movement, and I said, "Bill." And he looked up and says, "Jimmy."
Rescue crews arrived on the scene, and finally, Bill emerged from that sinkhole.
I had a sneaking hunch that if anybody was going to figure this out, if Jimmy made it down there, he'd be the one.
All thanks to a friend who saw him through the dark.
You don't turn your back. If somebody's in distress, you try to help.
I guess you take coming home every night for granted.
In Pierce County, Jamie Tompkins, Q13 News.
It is now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we'll take a look at your 3-day forecast.
Times River Schools Today, we'll be right back.
Another day has gone. I'm still all alone.
Starting off sports tonight, raising a child with special needs can be a challenge. Parents want their children to have the same access to opportunities as other children. This can be tough when it comes to sports. But thanks to a children's charity and the Mavericks team, the landscape in Kansas City is changing for the better. Neil Jones reports.
It's difficult for a parent to endure, watching their special needs child being left out of almost every athletic event.
It's heartbreaking, you know, because, you know, he's in a wheelchair that he can't run and play just like his friends.
The Kansas City Mavericks hockey team, along with the folks at Variety KC, have been sponsoring special skating events for special children. The idea is simple, to give these kids an opportunity to get out on the ice and play a little hockey. So 14-year-old Maddox can actually play hockey, just like his big brother.
It gives him the opportunity to be active, be social, and belong just like anybody else.
Maverick star Bryce Inowoski is one of the players who volunteers to help.
This is awesome. It's so cool. This is his second time on his ice, and I think his brother's second time as well, so they don't get to come out here much. But I think you're having a great time, aren't you? You're enjoying it? Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, while the ability level might vary from child to child, they all seem to love it.
Really fun, and it's really cool how people score the goal. It's really loud. I love snapping the puck.
It's really cool.
For years, 7-year-old Isaac's watched his twin brother play sports. But today, it's his turn to shine.
He gets to come out, play hockey, meet the Mavericks, you know, which is totally cool.
This event leaves everyone, including parents, feeling good.
When he's here, I feel like I don't have to, like, people understand, you know.
Variety KC sponsors all kinds of sports events, all of which are adapted to these special kids.
Let's now take a look at your 3-day weather forecast. For tomorrow, the sun will be back, but a bit colder, with a high of 36 and a low of 25. For Friday, the clouds will be back with a high of 43. And finally, for Saturday, it'll be raining with a high of 53 and a low of 46.
And wrapping up tonight's show, we all know that cats have 9 lives, but they usually just have 18 toes. That's what makes Paws a cat in Minnesota special. He has 28 toes, which ties a Guinness Book World Record, Molly Rosenbelt reports.
Meet Paws, the polydactyl cat. She has 3 extra toes on each forepaw and 3 extra on her back paws. Owner Gene Martin says her genetic trait comes in handy.
Almost looks like a catcher's mitt. But she can walk on the edge of a drawer, for instance, because her feet kind of grip like this.
Gene's daughter's partner, Walter, is the one who rescued Paws on his maple syrup farm near Cokato.
She used to love it when I would have her sit on my lap and rub her belly, and she felt pretty safe, so eventually when she had kittens, she brought the kittens over to my farm and stashed them in a Studebaker truck I was working on.
And that's how she ended up with Gene. When she takes Paws to the vet to get her claws trimmed, Gene always reminds them to make sure they get all 28. They don't even charge her extra.
No, I told her once, I said, you really ought to charge her extra because she has so many more.
This 3-year-old feline phenom is special in more than one way.
And she can even say hello. It's really funny. She makes a lot of noises, but sometimes she says, hello, hello, hello.
Remember, if you have a story we'd like us to cover,
or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send it to InterSchool Mail to the TV21 studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in TV21 throughout the day to catch this show as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at your website, www.trschools.com/TV21.
Well, that wraps up tonight's show. From Times River Schools Today, I'm Grace Danesco.
And I'm Michael Boldo. Have a great night.